What if you could travel through the Earth, entering from the South Pole and exiting at the North? What do you think will gravity do? Pull you harder, let go, or you will just end up getting stuck at the center? Let us find what Newton figured out centuries ago and how his shell theorem holds the key to this journey through the heart of the planet. So, imagine being inside a hollow spherical shell, like living inside the Earth's crust, but with nothing else inside. Well, Newton's shell theorem tells us that the shell exerts no net gravitational force on a particle inside it. Now, this is true only if the shell is perfectly symmetrical and the particle lies entirely within the shell. If the particle were even slightly outside the shell, the net force would no longer be zero. Now, here's the interesting part. Each small part of the shell does exert a gravitational force on you in full agreement with the Newton's law of gravitation. But when you add up all these individual forces as vectors, something remarkable happens. They cancel each other out and the net gravitational force becomes zero. And this cancellation isn't random. It's a direct result of the perfect spherical symmetry of the shell. So imagine a tiny patch of mass on one side of you. There's an opposing patch on the exact opposite side of the shell. The patch that's further away exerts a weaker force, but there's more area out there. So you're surrounded by many such patches. On the other hand, the patches that are closer exert stronger forces, but there are fewer of them. And these opposing effects balance out beautifully. Now, in case of Earth, we know that if we assume uniform distribution of mass, the gravitational force acting on a particle would be maximum on the Earth's surface, and this would decrease as the particle moves away. However, if the particle moves inside, towards the center, the gravitational force would change due to two reasons. One, as we get closer to the dense inner core, gravity should increase. And two, it should decrease because you see this shell outside of the particle is becoming thicker. That, as we discussed earlier, has no net force on the particle. In a way, you could imagine it as peeling an onion, layer by layer, and as you go deeper, each outer layer you peel away doesn't affect gravity anymore. Only the core that's left inside your current radius matters. So, to establish a formula for the gravitational force inside the Earth, we will make a journey from one pole to the other. And let us say you are in a capsule moving through a tunnel from the South Pole to the North. And at some time, this capsule is at a distance r from the Earth's center. Then, at this instant, the net gravitational force on the capsule is only due to the mass mi in the sphere of radius r. Because this mass outside in this shell does not contribute to the gravitational force in any way. Further, we will assume that this mass inside is concentrated as a particle here at the center. Then we can go ahead and write the magnitude of gravitational force on the capsule as F is equal to G M M I, that is mass of the Earth inside, divided by R square. Now, since we have taken the Earth to be of uniform mass, it means it has uniform density rho as well. So if rho is constant, we can express density as mass upon volume of the sphere, which would be mi upon 4/3 pi r cube. Or you could also write density as total mass of the Earth divided by its total volume, and the two should be equal. Then, mi expressed in terms of its radius r and density rho using this equality would be 4 by 3 pi r cube rho. And if we put value of rho as this over here, we get mi is equal to r cube m upon capital R cube. Now, if we substitute this expression for mi into this equation, we get the gravitational force on the capsule as F is equal to G M capital M into R upon capital R cube. Now, if you observe this equation, what you'll see is that the magnitude of force decreases linearly as a capsule moves towards the center. And then at the center, when R becomes zero, the force becomes zero as well. So let us now write this equation in this form, where K is a constant replacing this cluster of constants. Also, we've put a minus sign here to indicate that F is pointing in a direction opposite R. And this equation is, you already know, in the form of Hooke's law. That means the capsule will oscillate quite like a block attached to a spring, with the mean position at Earth's center. And this equation tells us what happens next. That is, when the capsule reaches the Earth's center, it would continue to travel towards the North Pole and then back again the way any simple harmonic motion would happen. So you see, an object falling through Earth would oscillate forever. You could say it is a natural simple harmonic motion system powered by gravity itself. And this is less commonly known as a gravity train motion. And if we ignore air resistance and Earth's rotation, the trip from one side of the Earth to the other would take about 42 minutes. And what will stump you totally is that this 42-minute travel time through a tunnel is the same whether you go straight through the center of the Earth or drill a slanted tunnel between any two surface points, because the restoring force is always directed towards the center and scales linearly with distance. And if you want to know more about this, I've explained it in greater detail in the description below. Okay, now let us remember that Earth is not a perfect sphere, and in reality, it has mass distribution that is quite non-uniform. So if we plot a graph between the radius of Earth versus the gravitational force, for an idealized model of Earth, that is uniform mass, the relationship is linear. But in reality, when we consider that the mass is quite uneven, this is what we get. Just below the surface, that is the upper mantle, the gravitational force initially decreases slightly. It then rises modestly in the lower mantle region due to increased density. Finally, it drops off more steeply, but not linearly, to zero at the center, because the mass exerting force on the capsule starts shrinking rapidly. So you see, this looks linear, but it is actually not a straight line. So if you want to learn more on the topic of gravitation, including topics like gravitational potential energy, Kepler's law, etc., head over to this playlist that has all the lessons you need. And if you like this lesson, give it a thumbs up. That'll be helpful. And I will see you in the next lesson.